the next 3 years, the challenge is to reinvent the way that electric motors are made, to make them cheaper, faster, more efficient, lighter. I mean, you name it, that's what we want to do to it. This is like, if Goldilocks was making an electric motor, this is going to be the one she's going to fit, because it is going to be just right. We're trying to make a synchronous reluctance motor, and it's a type of motor that doesn't use magnets, and magnets are one of the components in these machines that makes them quite expensive to make. The manufacturing element of the project, all the different components that need to be made, how they should be made, what materials they should be made of, what machining is going to be required to make these components. We want to help change the future, drive the conversation of what electric machines and, you know, what the automobile can effectively be in 10, 20 years. And we think we've got some ideas that can really help and stand out now, develop this new technology in a way that a lot of people maybe aren't thinking about. You've got to say, at the end of the day, it's quite an exciting thing to get involved in. You know, this is still a new world, a new age. You know, effectively, electric motors, this is like your first Apple computer. As not many people, maybe know, you know, Steve Jobs did all right with the first one, second one came out, bit mad. You know, we're in that sort of area where we've got good products, got good ideas, but we haven't quite worked out all the kinks. We've got these ideas that are going in a sort of direction where some of it's good, some of it's bad. It's not quite standardised. People still want to buy a petrol engine over an electric. You know, you can't go out and fill your electric car up willy-nilly. But regardless, everyone knows, like Steve Jobs or Bill Gates would have done when they started out, computers is the future, electric motors is the future. And I hope to be one of those people that eventually turn around and go, that work that Nathan Dodd did, that helped to steer the course of electric machines in the right direction. So, fingers crossed, in 3 years, the future's bright, and I've been a part of it. Let's hope, eh?